morning to everyone.
Good morning, ma'am.
How are you, children?
Fine, ma'am.
Okay, did you get time to read the text? Read the chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. All of you read it?
Yes, ma'am.
What about the questions that I gave you as homework? Have you done that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes.
I'm not getting yes from all of you. I'm not getting yes from all of you.
Ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
It was very easy.
The questions were very easy.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. I finished it.
Okay.
I also finished.
Anybody else who has not completed?
No.
Which one?
The homework
questions about happy prince, right?
Yes, yes, happy prince.
Yes, ma'am, I've done.
Okay, all right. So let me ask you one by one, few questions. Okay, I want Ananta Krishnan to respond. Ananta Krishnan, unmute.
Ananta Krishnan, say the question.
Yes, Anantu, tell me, why was the prince called Happy Prince?
Ma'am, he is very happy.
Okay, the prince was very happy. How do you know that the prince was very happy?
The city's people say.
Okay, the people in the city, the people in the city called him Happy Prince. Okay, I agreed. He was happy. But there is one reason. How can you say that he was happy? Okay, Anandu, I'll ask Ridhu. Ridhu, tell me. Ridhu? Okay, unable to. Okay, unmute.
He lived in the palace where he got everything he needed.
Yes, very good. One reason is he lived in the palace. And the second reason that we find from the stories, he played and danced with his friends. He got everything he wanted. He played and danced with his friends. So from this, we know that he was very happy. Okay, next question is to Asin, where is Asin? Asin, just unmute. Asin is here?
Yeah.
I can't hear Asin. So, Ethan, question is to Ethan. Ethan? Unmute, Ethan. Yes. Prince says that he did not know what happened on the other side. The prince says that he did not know what happened on the other side. Why? What was the reason?
Because there was a high wall.
Yes, exactly. There was a high wall that separated the palace from the outside wall. Okay, there was a high wall that separated the palace from the outside world. So he did not know what lay on the other side. Very good. Okay, next question is to Alona. Alona Eldo. Unmute Alona. 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 Unmute. Alona. Can you hear me? Where is Alona?
From last year, Alona has this connectivity problem. She can't hear anything.
Okay. Then I'll move on to the other one. Bennett Anthony. Bennett, why was the happy prince crying? Why was the happy prince crying? Oh, Bennett is fixing his headset only. Krishnesh, unmute and tell me, why was the happy prince crying?
Yes, ma'am.
Why was the happy prince crying?
All the people are very sad.
Okay, the people in the city were sad. Okay. The happy prince was crying because he could see all the unhappiness around him. Okay. The happy prince was crying because he could see all the unhappiness around him. Next question is to Akshaj.
Yes, ma'am.
Akshaj, can you tell me what was the help done by the happy prince and the swallow to the woman?
The happy prince tell the swallow
what was the help done by happy prince and the swallow to the woman. Akshay, do you know the answer? Not sure of. Okay, Leonardo. Leonardo.
Sweden.
Where is Leonardo? Yes. Unmute Leonardo.
Happy Prince request.
Keep your mouthpiece close to your mouth.
The happy prince request this warlord to give princess red ruby to her.
Yes, very good, very good. Perfect answer. Good. Well done, Leonardo. The Thank happy you, prince requested the swallow to take the red ruby out of his throat and to give it to the woman. Okay, good. Binnu, next question is to you. Unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Who was helped by the happy prince and the swallow second time? Secondly, who was helped?
The boy. Huh? The boy.
Who was helped? Who was helped by the happy prince and the swallow? Secondly, first help was done to the woman. Second help was done to whom?
Writer.
An English writer.
Okay, the answer is writer. Did you get the answer? The happy prince and the swallow helped the writer.
Writer.
Okay. Tamlin Maria, unmuted. How was the writer helped? How was the writer helped? Tamlin Maria. Tamlin Maria, how was the writer helped by the prince and the swallow? Shabari, tell me the answer. Give me the answer.
Ma'am, the happy prince gave his two eyes.
Two eyes?
One eye.
One of the eyes.
I'm Aiden.
Yes. Where is Aiden? Happy prince gave one of his sapphire eyes to the writer. Okay.
Sapphire eyes to the writer.
Okay. All right. So children, that is where we stopped in the last class. So listen, we'll have a quick revision once again. Okay. The happy prince is a statue kept on the top of the city. One day when the swallow was migrating to a distant land, the swallow thought of taking a rest at the foot of the happy prince. Suddenly, when he was about to take rest, the swallow felt that a few drops of water falling on its body. And when it looked up, it saw that the happy prince was crying. Swallow was so amazed to see the statue crying, and it asked the statue, "Who are you?" So the statue replied, "His name is Happy Prince." So again, Swallow got confused. Swallow asked him, "If your name is Happy Prince, then why are you crying?" So the prince explained the reason of his tears. The prince told that when he was alive, he lived in the palace. He had a very good time. He played and danced with his friends in the garden. And there was a high wall that separated the palace from the outside world. So the prince did not know what was happening outside. But after his death, the people in the city built a big statue of the happy prince, and it was kept on the top of the city. So now he can see all the unhappiness around him, and that is the reason for his tears. So happy prince, after seeing the sorrow or difficulties of the people, he decided to help them. The first help given by the happy prince was... He requested Swallow to give his red ruby to the woman. Her son was not feeling well. So if she gets the ruby, she can sell it and get the money and food. Okay, so that was the first help. Is it not, children? Am I right? Yes. Am I right? Yes. So the first help done by the happy prince and the swallow was giving a red ruby to the woman. And the second help was... helping the little girl. Am I right? Let me hear the response. The second help was...
No.
All right. I was just testing you. Okay, good children. You're all listening. Okay, so the second help done by the happy prince and the swallow was... done to the writer. Okay, the second help was done to the writer. And what was the help given by the happy prince? Happy prince requested Swallow to give one of his sapphire eyes. Correct? Is it right? Yes. Okay, happy prince requested the Swallow to give one of his sapphire eyes to the writer so that he can buy wood and food. He was feeling so cold and he was starving. He did not have any good food to eat. So he requested the Swallow to take one of his sapphire eyes and give it to the writer so that he can get the food as well as he can buy the wood. Okay, that's where we stopped in the last class. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes, yes.
Yes,
very
yes.
Good.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. All right. Okay. Now we are going to continue. Page number 10. The paragraph where it starts like this. A little girl is standing. Yes.
Is this the question, the homework question you sent? How, who wrote the story? The happy
birthday. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, I had given you 9 questions and also 3 words to learn its spellings. I hope you have done that. Yes or no? Yes.
Yes.
All right, children, we'll continue. Page number 10. The paragraph starts like this. A little girl is standing there in the square below. She has no money. Take out my other eye and give it to her, said the prince. So children, I want you to underline the word little girl. Okay. Underline the word little girl in the text.
It is there.
Page number 10. Page number 10. The paragraph that begins with a little girl. You see that line? Little girl. So the third help done by the happy prince was to give another sapphire eyes to the little girl. Okay. The little girl is standing there in the square. What do you mean by square?
Excuse me.
The town square.
Town square.
Does it mean the square which we draw in mathematics?
No. No,
ma'am. The city square.
The city square.
Yeah, the city square. The square in mathematics is different, and the square, what we mean here, is different. Square means an open area. An open area surrounded by buildings. An open area surrounded by buildings in a city. Okay, an open area surrounded by buildings in a city. That means in a city, all the 4 sides will be covered or surrounded by buildings. And the center part, the center portion is what you call as square. Okay. An area where people can gather together. So a little girl is standing there in the square below. She has no money. So actually the girl lived her life by selling matchsticks. You know what is a matchstick? Do you? Yes. Have you seen a matchstick? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The girl lived her life by selling matchsticks. So one day when she was about to sell this matchsticks, the whole box of matchsticks fell into the gutter, into the water, and it became wet. So children, is it possible to light fire with the help of a wet matchstick?
No,
not at all possible.
No, ma'am.
Okay, so she lost all the matchsticks that was in her hand. And she was crying. She was crying by standing there in the square. And she was afraid that her father will scold her for losing all the matchsticks. So only after selling these matchsticks, she'll be able to get money. She lost all the matchsticks. It was fallen into the gutter. So she became very upset. She was crying a lot. So Happy Prince saw this. And he asked Swallow. He is again requesting, Swallow, Swallow, will you take my another sapphire eye and give it to the little girl? So what do you think, children? Will the swallow take the other sapphire eye?
Ma'am,
those who know the story, be quiet. Others tell me. Do you think that the swallow will take the other sapphire eye out of the prince?
No. The swallow will take the other sapphire eye.
Swallow will not take. What could be the reason?
Because
He cannot see.
Okay. Many of you are responding at the same time. Thank you for your response. Swallow obeyed Happy Prince for the two times. Okay. Red ruby was given to the woman, and one of the sapphire eyes was given to the writer. Also. Red ruby was given to the woman, and one of the sapphire eyes was given to the writer. This is the third time the Happy Prince is requesting. So normally Swallow should obey it, is it not? After all, the prince is requesting. But the third time, Swallow refuses. Swallow says, no, no, no. I will not take the other eye from you. What is the reason? If both eyes are lost?
Can't see the eyes.
Yeah, the prince will not be able to see anything. Okay. Will we be able to see if our eyes are lost?
No.
Even if we close our eyes for quite some time, we will not be able to see anything. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, Happy Prince wanted to give the other sapphire eye to the little girl. But Swallow says, no. I will not take the other sapphire eye from you. Because if I take out the other eye from you, you will not be able to see. You will go completely blind. Okay, so Swallow says, I cannot take out your other eye. You will not be able to see, said the Swallow. Okay, Swallow is so concerned about the prince. Okay, Swallow started liking the prince very much. They were together for quite a few days. Actually, Swallow was planning to migrate to another area. Okay, because the winter season was approaching. But Swallow remained with the Happy Prince, and Swallow felt so sympathetic towards Happy Prince because he wanted to give the other eye also. Do as I say, please. So look at this sentence, children. The prince is requesting at the same time.
He's commanding.
Very good, Alvina. Very good. Very good. Perfect answer. He's commanding. Okay. So the first two times he requested, Swallow, could you please take the red ruby and give it to the woman? Second time he requested, Swallow, could you please take one of my sapphire eyes and give it to the writer? Third time, when the Swallow said, no, I will not take the other eye out of you, the prince requested and he commanded, do as I say. That is a form of commanding. He's a prince after all, is it not? He's a prince. He has the full right. He has the full right to command to others. Okay, so do as I say. That is a command. And the next part is please. It is a request. Did you understand, children? If yes, give me a thumbs up. If that is clear, give me a thumbs up. Okay, very good, very good. Do as I say, please, replied the prince. The bird took out the prince's eye, flew to the girl and put the jewel in her hand. So where was the girl standing?
In the square.
Yes, the girl was standing in the square. And what was she doing? What was she doing?
She was crying.
He was crying. Yes, the girl was standing in the square and she was crying. So prince requested and commanded at the same time. So the Swallow took the other sapphire eye out of the prince. It flew to the little girl and it dropped the sapphire eye into the hands of the little girl. So what is in the little girl's hand? What is there in the little girl's hand?
Sapphire eyes.
Yes, sapphire eyes. Okay, very good. Sapphire eye. One of the eyes of the prince is there in the hands of the little girl. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now take page number 11. The prince now depended on the Swallow. The prince now depended on the Swallow to describe whatever he saw. Somebody has not muted. Is it Ethan? Ethan?
Yes.
All right. So the prince started depending on Swallow. Why? What's the reason? What is the reason? Why did prince start depending?
He's blind.
Yes, the prince has become blind. The prince has become blind. He can't see anything now. He cannot see anything now. So he started depending fully on Swallow. Whenever the prince heard of some suffering, He asked Swallow to take off one piece of gold from his body and give it away. So both the sapphire eyes was given to one to the writer and another to the little girl. Red ruby was given to the woman. Now what is remaining with the prince? What is remaining?
Gold.
The gold. Yes.
The body, gold.
His body was built up with gold. Isn't it? Statue was made of gold. So only gold was remaining. So whenever he heard that some people were suffering, some people were going through tough times or difficult times, he asked Swallow to take a bit of gold from his body and give it to the people who were suffering. Okay. So the people who got gold, they became so happy. Winter set in. Now the climate has become very, very cold. Okay. Winter. Winter season approached. Are you all with me? Children, are you all with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. We are moving to the climax of the story. The winter set in, but the swallow stayed back. See? Now, Swallow, actually, he was planning to migrate to distant land.
Ma'am, I read this, this story. And last swallow died.
Yes. So Swallow stayed back. Swallow did not want to leave Happy Prince at all. Okay, they became close friends. They became so attached with each other. Isn't it? Just like you make close friends in the classroom. And once you become close, you wanted to leave the other person. Am I right? If two of the close friends are sitting together, you never want to even to change your seats. Am I right? When the teacher comes and shifts your seat to the next person, you will start crying. Yeah, just the same way Swallow and Happy Prince, both of them became so close to each other. It grew colder and colder. Nevertheless, the swallow did not leave. The climate became so cold, but Swallow did not leave. Even though the climate became so cold, Swallow did not leave the Happy Prince. Mm-hmm. One day, gathering up his last bit of strength, the swallow flew up, said goodbye to the prince and fell dead at his feet. Oh my goodness, what happened at the end? One day gathering. What do you mean by gathering? Gathering means?
Taking everything.
Yes, yes. Collecting. Gathering means collecting. Taking up everything. Taking up his full strength. Okay. Just remember, swallow is a small bird. Swallow is a little bird. Okay. It will not be able to withstand with the cold climate. Children, just imagine that I'm going to take you all to Europe. Huh? Just for the time being, you just come along with me to Europe. What is the climate there in Europe?
Very cold.
The climate cold. Is very, very cold. Okay, not like our climate. Climate in Europe is very, very cold. And if after reaching in Europe, and if you do not have enough sweaters or blankets to make yourself warm, what will happen? Will you be able to make yourself comfortable?
No.
No, you will not be comfortable. You will be very, very uneasy. So just imagine a small bird swallow. Swallow is facing a lot of cold climate. Okay, swallow is not able to bear the cold. So last, it gathered all its strength, flew up to the face of the statue. And it said, goodbye. Goodbye, dear prince. I love you. It said, goodbye, dear friends. I love you so much. And finally, it fell dead at the feet. What happened? Huh?
The bird
just
died.
Because of the cold climate, Swallow was not able to live anymore. Okay. It just lost its life. The people noticed the statue, bare of all the jewels. What do you mean by bare of bare?
Bare
means? Bare means?
Had.
No, barefoot, barefoot,
barefoot.
Do not walk barefoot.
He didn't put anything, like all the gold was gone.
I'm just asking you the meaning of the word bare. Bare means without. Bare means without.
Without.
Yes, barefoot means without wearing shoes or without wearing chappal. Okay, barefoot. So bare, people notice the statue, bare of all the jewels. Bare of all the jewels means?
He didn't have any jewels on
his body. Yes, yes. The statue lost all the jewels. Two sapphire eyes were gone. Red ruby was gone. And what about the gold? That also was gone. Okay. Everything. The prince gave of everything that he had. Bear of all the jewels. And pulled it down and threw it along with the dead swallow. Okay. So the next day, then when the mayor and the other authorities and the people came to the center of the city, they saw that the statue's condition was so bad. Statue was in a shabby condition because all the gold that covered the statue was gone. He did not have the sapphire eyes and the red ruby was also gone. So they thought of destroying the statue. They don't want the statue anymore to be there in the at the top of the city because it did not look so good. Okay. It did not look so good. So they wanted to destroy the statue. So they threw it along with a dead swallow. So people did not know what had happened. But they thought that a little swallow was there dead at the foot of the statue and the statue has become so shabby. It was in a poor condition. So the swallow, the dead swallow was thrown away. At the same time, the statue was also thrown away. However, those who had received help had love and gratitude in their hearts for the happy prince and the swallow. So who are the ones who received help? Who are the ones who received help? One was
I'm happy prince and swallow.
Who were the ones who received help from happy prince
and swallow? The lady, the
woman. Yes. Yes. The woman. The writer. And the little girl. Okay.
Little girl and woman.
Yes, you have to by heart this. Okay, the woman, the writer,
and the little girl.
Little girl.
Woman. Writer.
Yes, so three of them were helped by the swallow and the happy prince. So they had a great love and gratitude. What do you mean by gratitude? Gratitude means?
Good manners.
Okay, of course, it is a good manner. But I'm asking you the meaning, gratitude. Gratitude means thankfulness. When somebody does some help for us, we would say thank you. Don't we?
Yes.
Don't we say thank you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes.
And this is what you mean by gratitude. Okay.
Gratitude.
Yes, thankfulness. Gratitude means thankfulness. Yes. So, the people who received help from Happy Prince and the Swallow, they had a great love and thanks or gratitude in their hearts. Okay. So, that's how the story ends. Okay, the happy prince and the swallow, they are not there. But in the eyes of God, they are the best people. They are the best ones because they helped one another. They helped the other people. So what is the moral or message that we get from the story?
Always help others.
Help others.
Yes, always help others. Okay, always help others.
Care for others, make others happiness.
Yes, make others happy. Okay, so whenever you get a chance, you have to help each other. You have to make others happy. Let me quickly show you. I hope I can show you the picture. I do not know. I'm not sure. Can you see the picture, children?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I just wanted to show you some picture. We are winding up the story. This is what I wanted to show, the palace, image of palace. Okay, beautiful garden is there. Okay, happy prince. This is the real palace.
Sure, this statue.
Okay.
Is happy prince real?
No, it's not real. But this is somehow I thought of connecting the chapter with that.
You can show the statue.
Yeah, I will. Okay, I'll show you the image of statue. Statue, I think I have showed you before.
Yeah,
it's good.
You can see the golden
statue. I'm in YouTube this story.
Yeah, then this is what you mean by square, an area which is surrounded by buildings. See, in the center part, you can see the people can stand or they can sit, but on all the four sides, it will be covered with building.
Yeah.
Okay, image of a square. Okay, that's all, children. We have come to the end of our chapter. You have enjoyed and you have understood. Yes or no?
Yes.
Any doubts? Any doubts regarding the chapter?
No.
Okay, so read your text thoroughly. Okay, I'll send you some questions today. You have to write the answers by yourself. Okay, and notes I will note it. Just copy down into the rule sheets.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, Jen. Thank you,
ma'am. Bye.